What's up, brothers? Hope everybody's doing well out there. Before we get this one started, I want to shout out all the Chads, all the Giga Chads, all the Tyrones, and all the PSL gods. Anyways, in today's video, I want to talk about why you should not take women seriously. Now, I should say that if men stop taking women seriously, I'd be out of business. So, you know, maybe I don't mean that quite literally, but I do have a point that I want to drive home in this video, because there's a lot of guys out there, you know, that are really struggling when it comes to these concepts, you know. And there's guys out there that are killing themselves. There's guys out there that are becoming drug addicts or alcoholics. Guys out there that are doing crazy things to chase after the bag in hopes of attracting more women, you know. And it's not that serious, man. It's not worth it, you know. You shouldn't be taking women that serious. Now, the problem that guys run into, you know, in the industry that I'm in here, the biggest problem that guys run into is they meet a woman early on, like, you know, early on in their friendship or relationship, they become very serious with that woman. They become very committed, very invested into that woman. And the reality of the modern dating game is that women have a lot of options. You know, some men have a lot of options, but all women have a lot of options. So, a lot of times a woman will sort of keep you on the hook, and you'll think it's something really serious, but in reality, you're maybe like third place. You know, you're not super high ranked. That's just the reality of the situation. And you know, even those really nice, innocent girls, and you want to play nice guy, and you think she's real sweet, nice, and innocent, the reality of the situation is she's probably not. You know, I can't tell you how many times I've been out in public, and, you know, I'll see a girl, somebody that I've hooked up with, and she's with her man that I didn't even know she had. You know, and as I walk past her, she's kind of giving me a look like, don't say anything. You know, play it cool. This is my man. Don't say anything. You know, that's kind of what she's saying when she looks at me. So I kind of pick up on it, and I'm like, all right, I'll just act like I don't even know you. That's the reality of the game. You know, that is the shit that happens. And, you know, even myself in a situation like that, I could feel slighted by that. I could say, well, what the fuck? I thought we had something. But in reality, you know, I was the more exciting dick on the side, and she already has somebody that she's been with for quite some time. So I just have to accept that fate and say, you know what, I'm not even going to take this shit serious. But you should still move as a man with morals and integrity, because that's going to be the square that you stand on. That's who you are as a man. That's your character. And it's, you know, it's important that you maintain that at all costs. So let me tell you this, you know, if I meet a woman and, you know, I'm attracted to her, I'm interested in her, but I don't really know her like that, so we're not that serious yet, I can't allow myself to be invested in her. Here's how I should put it. The number one skill that you need to learn when you're in this dating game is minding your own fucking business. Because what happens with these guys is they meet a woman early on, they get super invested in that woman, and they come to the realization the hard way, the rude awakening, that she's talking to a lot of men, she's hooking up with a lot of men, and that's when they get depressed, that's when they want to off themselves, you know, that's when, you know, maybe they go black-pilled or they go MGTOW and they say, you know, this dating game isn't worth it, dating is dead, so on and so forth. But that could have all been prevented by minding your own fucking business. You see, if you're a man that has integrity, you do the right thing, right? You know, you don't screw anybody over. You're not going behind anybody's back. You're not cheating on anybody. You're not you're not really doing anything wrong. Like, you're standing on your square, you have good character, you're a good man, and sometimes you bump into people that just aren't good people. You know, they're willing to betray you. They don't have that same level of character that you have. So the best thing that you can do is mind your own business. That way, you don't know what the fuck she's doing. You don't stress out about it. And eventually, the truth always comes out anyways, right? But by moving with integrity and minding your own business, not overreacting, not giving a shit, just going on with your life, when you do find out that she is for the streets, you know, this is when you can say, you know what, shame on you. You know, that might sound corny, but shame on her, right? Shame on that bitch. But you didn't do anything wrong. You know, you can still move with integrity. You can still have a smile on your face. You can still keep it pushing. She gave you the pussy. You know, she is out hoeing. You're one of the dudes. You're one of the cocks on the carousel. Whatever you want to call it. You're a player that's in the game. You know, there's so many guys out there that are scared to get their asses in that game. And then there's so many guys that get in that game and, you know, they don't really know how to control their emotions. So, you know, shit happens and they're all heartbroken and all that. But you can be a guy that minds your own business, moves with integrity, moves exactly the way you should move. You're honest. You know, you have no regrets, no reason to apologize or feel guilty about anything. But at the same time, you know, you're out there and you're getting yours. You're making shit happen. So, yeah, man, that's all I want to say in this video. I guess that's not too deep of a message, but all the guys out there that are really, you know, getting in too deep with these women, that these ain't shit bitches, that shouldn't really even, you know, they shouldn't have any power in your life at all. You should be a man with character, moving with integrity, moving how you want to move in a respectful way. And when people slight you, when people betray you, people cheat on you, shame on them. You know, that's really all it comes down to. And when you have the clear conscience, you know, you understand that you did what you were supposed to do. You've done your job correctly. But some people, some shady characters will walk into your life and they will not move correctly. You know, they will not move with integrity. You know, that's just the real pill that you have to swallow. You know, you don't want to end up one of these guys, you know, that's either suicidal or that, you know, is just so black-pilled that he thinks dating is totally dead, it's totally over with. You know, you got to have some thick skin, get your ass out there in the game and understand, yeah, these girls are all fucking. And they're usually fucking more than one guy too. And the only thing you can really do is jump in there and, you know, either play the game or the game will go on without you. You know, it'll either pass you by or you can jump on the ride. You know, and eventually somebody will come along that you share that mutual trust for, that, you know, moves with the same integrity that you do. And that's when, you know, you can have something a bit more serious, you know. So, until then, you just got to understand, man, it's not serious. It's not that fucking serious. You know, you can just enjoy yourself and mind your own fucking business. Minding your own fucking business is the best skill you can ever possibly have, because it keeps you out of trouble and it keeps you sane. It keeps you from killing yourself. You know, a lot of guys, what they do, you know, when they start to have suspicion that a girl's cheating or something, they stop minding their own business, right? They start digging into her business. And when they dig into her business, they uncover, you know, that whole mess. And they realize that it was all a lie, you know. Everything they dreamt of was a lie. And that's when they want to kill themselves. So, mind your own business. The truth always comes out anyways. Move with integrity. And, you know, just learn that not everybody's going to have the same integrity as you. So you can't take them too serious. Literally, you catch a girl cheating on you. Your exact thought should be, shame on you. You know, I thought we could have had something here, but shame on you. You know, I'm moving along. Because, you know, if we've learned anything with like Adam 22 or, you know, the shit that's going on, man. You know, if another man's sticking his dick in your girl, that relationship's trash. It's a waste of time. Motherfucking helicopters always riding through my neighborhood. It wouldn't be an LFA video without a helicopter, gunshots, police sirens. You know, we have a good time out here, but I mind my own business, so I don't really have any problems myself. All right, guys, hope this message got through to the right people that it needs to get through to. And you know, shout out to the Chads, the Tyrones, Giga Chads, Giga Tyrones, PSL gods. You know, all the winners out there. All right, guys, I'm gonna bounce. Peace.
To the window, to the wall, until the sweat drops down my balls, until all you bitches crawl. Oh, skeet, skeet, goddamn.